Who are you going to believe tonight? Which side? My question goes to Gopal Jain, not Gopal Subramaniam. Gopal, you know, we have two sides. Now, the government says that, look here, we are against Gopal Subramaniam becoming a judge because, you know, his name comes up in some Neera Radia conversation. You know, because he's generally seen to allow his spirituality to overtake his legal logic. He's too spiritual up to a point of letting it overtake his legal reasoning. I mean, there's a suggestion in some intelligence bureau note, you know, and it says it because there was some meeting between him and Raja's lawyers. And they say the reason we are not removing him is nothing to do with the fact that he bitterly opposed bail for Mr. Amit Shah. It has nothing to do with the fact that he took on the Gujarat police and exposed how they botched up investigation in the Sohrabuddin case and that he made adverse observations about the Gujarat police. They say this has nothing to do with Amit Shah. Now, can you buy that logic, Gopal?
No, enough. Yes. First thing, there's a no third side and the most important side, which is the interest of the institution. Now, this year, the Supreme Court is seeing several retirements and we are going to have a new look Supreme Court. Therefore, we need the best drawn from both the higher judiciary as
That's
well as...
That's okay. You made that point. Is Gopal the best
the
in your view?
Let's take a look.
Let's be very specific. Is Gopal
is what,
of that fine metal to be a Supreme Court judge or not? Or do you believe that, you know, what the government says about some IB report and CBI report is stronger than, you know, his individual abilities?
Arnab, I'm saying a person is appointed, designated by the Supreme Court as a senior advocate. You have been an amicus curiae. A person has been a solicitor general. A person has done legal aid work. What is the profile of a Supreme Court judge? All of these are obviously important constituents which will be determined.
That's all right. Don't couch your words carefully. Gopal, I hear you.
And the last... The last word under the Supreme Court judgment is of the court. If the government has objections and material, it has to go for reconsideration to be decided by the Chief Justice and the Collegium. So ultimately, the initiating authority, that is the recommending authority, and the deciding authority is the court.
You're saying the President's clearance does not matter.
The input which the government
is entitled to give. Are you saying the President is a rubber stamp and his view does not matter?
Entitled to give. No, the Chief Justice and the court under the Supreme Court judgment have the last word in saying so-and-so or so-and-so is or is not to be a judge of the Supreme Court. Once that happens, it goes to the President. So my short point is, what is the signal it sends out? Will we really get good top people coming to the Supreme Court, which is important in a 21st century Supreme Court?
So here's the question. I think, Pinky Anand, all eyes at this stage of the debate are on you, Miss Anand. Here is a person who becomes senior advocate of the Supreme Court at the young age of 37, has been Solicitor General of India, resigns on a matter of principle as Solicitor General of India, has been amicus curiae to the country's highest court on several important issues, and is generally acknowledged to be among the top three or four lawyers in the Supreme Court today, though that's an arguable list. Suddenly, Ms. Pinky Anand, and this is the great mystery. Suddenly, we are told the man is, you know, his whole ability, or rather, should I not say, that his record is under dispute. That he's not good enough to be a Supreme Court judge.
Arnav.
No, one second. The simple question
Arnav,
to you tonight
moment,
is.
Can I now?
No, the simple question to you tonight is, you don't think today this realization has come suddenly, too late, and too coincidentally after the BJP came to power?
My short response to you is the following.
Yes.
Whenever any Supreme Court judge or a High Court judge is appointed, you do have intelligence reports which have to give a report whether the person...
So when a person becomes Solicitor General, there's no vetting?
Suddenly or otherwise...
No, a person can become Solicitor General without any intelligence bureau or CBI vetting. No, tell me that.
Arnab, I don't think the Solicitor General period was relevant at that point of time.
No, why is it not relevant?
First of all,
Indira Jaisingh, you buy that? Indira Jaisingh, you buy that?
There is. Arnab, allow me to complete only two statements to say this.
You
have intelligence reports for appointment of all judges, and those intelligence reports are put before the
counter.
The government is part of this consultative process of appointment of judges.
That's all right. You don't tell me about the process. Answer the question here.
Intelligence report. There is. There is an intelligence report here which is negative, whether you like it or you don't like it.
It's not a question of whether I like it or don't like it. I am asking you whether intelligence bureau reports are carved to suit the government, the government's convenience.
Not if they were, Arnab, then you should cast aspersions on all intelligence reports. The procedure that has been prescribed is that intelligence reports comes in for all the judges.
No, no, but how can the intelligence bureau, how can the intelligence bureau not be consistent with its own views?
That is not the
question. No, no, one second.
You are
no,
not
Pinky
talking
Anand.
About a individual. You are talking about a system that has to come into.
I am talking about
a
individual.
You have to allow a system to operate.
I am not
if
talking in a hypothetical situation.
Operate,
I am. No, 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 one second. No, no, I am not talking. I am talking about a man called Gopal Subramaniam. I am not talking in some vacuum.
In his case.
I am talking about a man called Gopal
Subramaniam. There is an adverse intelligence report. And the government.
Oh, why was there no adverse intelligence report when he was made Solicitor General by the UPA government?
And instead of no.
Why was there no adverse intelligence report when he was made Solicitor General by the UPA government?
If I'm not mistaken,
Have intelligence reports at the appropriate period of time. You have the intelligence report coming in when he's being considered for appointment as Supreme Court judge. At this point of time,
okay, count us. First, Brijesh Kalappa.
That is what has been considered.
Yes, Mr. Kalappa, counter from you.
I was only trying to say, Arnab, as far as Pinky Anand is concerned, if I'm not mistaken, I think Mr. Gopal Subramaniam was a classmate. And I don't think, you know, this kind of a brief should have been given to her. Because Mr. Subramaniam is genuinely respected. He's a person of outstanding eminence. There is no doubt at all about it.
Who you persecute?
The entire bar knows of this.
No. A person so eminent, so respected, that you made his professional life unlivable and forced him to resign as Solicitor General. A person so respected that you're... Let me complete, Mr. Kalappa. Don't speak over me now because I'm about to say something uncomfortable to you. A person so respected... Mr. Kalappa, you have a very bad habit, and that bad habit amounts to stopping somebody when he wants to say something that is not convenient to you. A person so respected, Mr. Kalappa, that on the 26th of July, and I have an elephant's memory on these issues, on the 26th of July 2011, when he resigned, he was forced to write a letter to Kapil Sibal, where he criticized the Congress government for not revealing the extent of criminality in the 2G case to its own Solicitor General. You let him down, you betrayed him, and today you want to shoot over his shoulder, and I find that inappropriate.
At least this fact.
Am I right or wrong?
At least this fact will let you know that the Congress party is distanced from Mr. Gopal Subramaniam.
Oh, please. I know enough about political parties not to trust
this fact. This is the fact that you brought up. I did not bring up this fact.
Two independent, competent lawyers.
I did not bring up this fact.
And the system as a whole.
Okay, Indira Jaisingh, last word tonight. Do you take the word of Pinky Anand? Do you think this controversy is going to go away, or is it going to blow up?
I don't think this controversy is going to go away. I come back to the point, the collegium system has failed because of the failure of institutions. Can Pinky answer the question? There is one IIB report that clears him. There is one IIB report that is adverse to him. Which one is correct? You know, are they both right? Are they both wrong? Is one right, the other wrong? It is a generated report, generated after NDA has come to power. I repeat,
and
I have Indira no
ji,
doubt in my mind that this has happened because he appeared in the Sohrabuddin case. There is no doubt in my mind about that. And that issue is not going to go away.
If collegium system is failure, what was UPA doing for 10 years in power? What was UPA doing 10 years in power?
Listen, Arnab. Arnab, please listen to me. Arnab, please let me say what I have to say.
I don't know, Indira, where you are headed.
We are the people of India. We
the
people of India.
The collegium system has failed for the reason.
Please allow me to complete.
You have appointment of judges. Are you challenging the appointment of all judges?
Will you please ask her to keep quiet?
Why? It's just Arnab, because it's politically inappropriate for you.
Quiet.
Therefore, you cast aspersions on
then
all of us.
Let her speak.
Are you casting aspersions on the Supreme Court?
Please allow me to finish. I I am questioning the methodology used by the Supreme Court to make appointments. That does not amount to casting aspersions at all. Please
so
listen.
Are you saying they should have recommended him in the first
I'm
place?
I'm telling you, we are
what
the people
the
of India.
Of objection to the Supreme
and
Court
we
action?
Have a right to know. If will she keep quiet and will you allow me to continue?
Complete your point. Complete your point. Running short of time. Yes, complete your point.
Yes, yes, Arnab, we the people of India have a right to know what kind of people are being recommended for appointment, why they're being recommended, why they're being rejected. It is the BJP that promised us this in their election manifesto. They must redeem their promise, make the data available to us. Release the report, release the IB report, release the CBI report, so that we can take our own intelligent decisions on the subject. We don't need to be told by Pinky what to think.
Right. If the report on NGOs can be made available, I think the report on
you cannot have selected release of intelligence reports.
Okay,
you're asking.
It is important.
Be individualized. Either
it is important to today ask whether the CBI and the IB are independent enough to give a fair report. And can these reports be tutored or not?
Well, if the report on NGOs could be made available, we'll be very happy to carry the report on Gopal Subramaniam. But the government must release those reports. Let's see if that happens. Thank you very much. Is this going to blow up or close? I don't know. But it appears to me for now it's not going away immediately. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me on debate number one on the News Hour tonight.